Yo, what's good everyone? Coach D here with The Shift Method Personal Training, coming to y'all with another video. We're gonna be talking about a tier list, like we saw in the last one, where we were focusing on the arms, the bicep, the triceps, and the shoulders. But today, we're focusing on the chest. How are you gonna build the best chest possible if you're someone who's looking to look better, feel better, have a bigger chest, and that's a muscle you wanna focus on? I'm gonna give you a list of 15 of some of the best and some of the worst exercises, from my opinion, so y'all can check out what to add to your program. And of course, if y'all enjoyed this video, please be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Let me know what your favorite and least favorite chest-based exercises are. I would love to hear y'all's opinions in the comments down below, but let's go ahead and get started. All right, so y'all know the deal. If you haven't seen the last video again, for the one in the arms, I'm gonna link it down in the description below. And if you've seen these tier videos, it's gonna be kind of a similar format. Every time an exercise comes up, we're gonna leave it on the tier list here, and it goes from F to S. F being a failure of an exercise, not very good for developing the chest, all the way up to S tier, meaning it is going to be the best exercise. And at the end, I'm gonna go ahead and crown what I think is the best builder for the chest, which is gonna be our S tier plus exercise. So make sure you stick around to the end so you can see what I give the best chest exercise, in my opinion, as a coach who's worked with athletes from strength development standpoint, building muscle standpoint, and of course, focusing on different aspects of the body, specifically people wanting to build their chest up. Okay, so again, we gotta talk about what makes an exercise good for developing the chest. And again, there's kind of synonymous things for building muscle in general. So let's go ahead and knock out a few of those points so you understand what my criteria is for developing the chest. First and foremost, a big thing when we talk about building muscle is you gotta have good tension, specifically at what we call the bottom or the lengthened part of the movement. To give a very easy example, when we're thinking of a bench press, you have the top of the movement where your arms are fully extended, and the bottom of the movement when the bar or the dumbbells or whatever are at your chest. What we see when we're trying to build muscle now, and kind of the more modern research, is that if I can get a lot of tension at the bottom of a movement, where the muscles most stretch, that's gonna be really, really good for building muscle mass. And so that's what I'm looking for. Do I have a good stretch at the bottom or at the end portion of a particular movement? The second thing is, do I feel it in my chest? Does it actually stimulate the chest a lot? Or are there a lot of other muscles involved? Obviously, with a lot of chest exercise, which you are gonna see, there's other muscles involved, like the triceps, the shoulders, etc. But is the chest the main muscle we're focusing on? And do I mostly feel it in the chest? Or do other muscles kind of take over and like overactivate when I should be just focusing on the chest specifically? So I want to make sure activation is at the forefront of my exercise. Also, how does it kind of feel on your joints? This one's a little bit anecdotal, of course. And so using my coaching experience, of course, with myself personally and talking with other coaches, thinking which exercise tends to feel really good on people's joints and where they just pretty much feel it in the muscle versus which ones it's like, man, I don't know, time and time again, it just seems like this one doesn't do very well. Not to say that's a bad exercise, but it just seems to aggravate people's joints, whether it's their shoulder or their elbows or their wrists, whatever it may be, what muscle or what exercise is activating the muscle best and not overdoing it on the joints. And lastly, can I progress the exercise pretty easily or even make it easier if I need to? Can I regress it? Because as we know, for building muscle, I have to increase the intensity of the exercise generally on a week-to-week basis, whether that's adding more weight, adding more sets, adding more reps, or maybe modifying it to make it harder. Is that something I can do? And of course, if I'm starting out and I'm trying to build my chest, can I make the exercise regress a little bit to make it easier for my fitness level versus an exercise might be a little bit complicated? Maybe it doesn't have a very good entry point. It's hard to set up. That is kind of my final criteria. What is the progression or regression look like for the exercise that I'm doing? Okay, now that we kind of got the criteria down, let's go ahead and jump into the tier list here. All right, first and foremost, we got to talk about probably the most popular exercise for developing the chest, and that is going to be the barbell bench press. This is like the staple, right? Every person, when they're first getting into weight training, generally when they think of how am I going to work my chest, my upper body, the bench press is usually the first thing they go to, and it is a really, really good exercise for developing the chest. I'm actually gonna give this one a solid B. Okay. If I could add a plus or minus, I'm gonna give it a B plus here. Again, the chest, what is it responsible for? It's a pushing muscle, so the ability to bring my arms forward, and of course also to bring my arms together, kind of like what you think when you see like a fly-based exercise, right? And so the bench press, the barbell bench press, does a really good job of pushing your arms forward, and so it really does develop the chest in a very good way. It also allows for a pretty solid range of motion, right? If you can control and go all the way down to your chest, you get a really good stretch at the bottom for your chest. And so it ultimately gives you a good range of motion, good tension at the bottom. Some caveats to this as to why I'm not making it a little bit higher on the list is because, of course, it does have a bit of a learning curve, right? It does take time to get used to this movement. It is a free weight exercise where you're not on a fixed track. And so if this is your first ever exercise for your upper body that you're learning, or first exercise for your chest, there is quite a bit of a learning curve. And of course, making sure your form is good, making sure you're not doing too much weight to where maybe you start having some aggravation in the joints, that is something to consider. But overall, it's a pretty safe and very effective exercise. Really, really solid staple of any program, not just for building muscle, but definitely if you want to build the chest up, a barbell bench press is a very solid exercise. Next one is going to be the incline barbell bench press. This is personally one of my favorite chest exercises, and it really has all the benefits of a traditional barbell bench press, but with the slight added benefit of now we're putting a little bit greater emphasis on the upper portion of our chest. So if you look at like a quick anatomy diagram, I'll put one up here for y'all. You have kind of two main portions of your chest. Yes, there's a lower portion, but in terms of like how it's divided anatomically, you have the upper portion, or the upper clavicular part that kind of goes up to your collarbone, and you have kind of just your regular lower portion and middle portion of your chest here. And so this does actually put a greater emphasis, because you're at kind of that incline, on the upper portion of your chest. But again, with all the awesome benefits of the traditional bench press, since it's very similar with tension, with range of motion, a little bit of a learning curve like the bench press, but overall a solid exercise, I gotta put this one also at B tier. Okay. It is phenomenal to add to a program. Now let's go to some dumbbell exercises. Dumbbell bench press. Very similar to the traditional bench press, but what's unique about this is I have the ability to move my arms from being further apart at the bottom to bringing them together at the top. Because of this slight change, I'm actually gonna move this one over to A tier. Because what I mentioned with the chest, yes, it's responsible for pushing, like a push-up or a bench press, but it's also responsible for bringing my arms together at the top of a movement, which I can't do with the barbell. That's kind of one of the limiting factors of not getting as much activation of the chest. So a dumbbell bench press where I can make a nice wide grip at the bottom, maybe even go a little bit past my chest because now that bar isn't touching, and then bring them together at the top, that allows me to get a little bit more in the chest. And so this one is a phenomenal exercise. Definitely, again, going in A tier. Again, there's a little bit of a learning curve, and because each limit is working independently, you might notice that maybe one arm can do a little bit more than the other, and you're a little bit more unstable. So there is kind of that slight downside, but you can start with quite light dumbbells, right? Whereas the barbell, you may only have a 45-pound barbell. You can go as light as 5 pounds, 10 pounds on a dumbbell bench press, and then progress from there. So a phenomenal safe exercise. And then incline dumbbell bench press, also got to give this one an A. Same benefits as the dumbbell bench, right? I can go wide at the bottom, bring them together up top. As long as I got that incline somewhere around 30 to 45 degrees, I get to target the upper fibers of my chest. I get to progress it easily. It's a really awesome exercise. And again, really just the learning curve and the fact that it's a single arm exercise or unilateral exercise, there's a stability element to it, but overall a phenomenal exercise for building your chest. A's all around here. And of course, there's one more bench press exercise you can talk about here with dumbbells. It's gonna be a decline dumbbell bench press. Again, this one isn't a bad exercise. You can actually load it quite well. But the issue is sometimes the setup can be a little bit awkward, especially if you're trying to do it for the first time and figuring out, okay, how do I lock myself into either a decline sit-up or a decline bench that has an attachment that can hold my legs? And of course, figuring out, okay, now that I finished my last rep, like how do I put the dumbbells down, or do I have to do a sit-up to get back up? It can be a little awkward there. And the decline does have slightly less range of motion, and it can be very awkward with yourself where your head is lower than your body, trying to figure out where to position your arms. So again, still a really good exercise. I'm gonna give it a B here, right? It does let you move your arms in that position where you go wide at the bottom together at the top. You can progress it quite well, but because the setup and the finish can be a little bit awkward, I gotta knock this one down just a little bit. All right, next is the seated pec fly machine. This is gonna be our first S tier exercise. This one is phenomenal. Really, really easy to set up. It's a fixed machine, so it really helps isolate the chest. You don't really have to worry about too much of other muscles getting involved or getting fatigued, right? Like on the bench press variations, maybe the triceps kick in too much. In this one, you're pretty much fixing and isolating the pecs pretty much exclusively. So it's really, really nice for isolating the chest and working it as much as possible. It's also very easy to progress and regress. It's a selectorized machine, so you just have to move the pin, which usually does 5 to 10 pound increments. So you can get very precise with how you want to adjust it. And again, it has that ability for you to bring your arms together, which is very, very good for ultimately activating the chest. You can also set the range of motion to whatever works best for you. So if you're someone who maybe struggles with shoulder range of motion, maybe you only put it to where your arms are not even to the parallel side. If you have really good range of motion, you really want to get a good stretch, you can bring your arms back as far as you can. And so really, really good for emphasizing that stretch. You got a lot of tension at the end of the movement. And because it's a machine, because it's generally used with a cable, the tension is pretty constant. And so that's what you want. Nice, smooth, it's nice and constant. And mostly people do have pretty good feeling with this one compared to something maybe like a dumbbell fly. People tend to say this one feels pretty good on the shoulders and on the elbows. And so this is one of my favorite bench press exercises. I gotta give this one an S tier. Next is dumbbell flies. So this one is going to be a B. It's not as good as the seated cable pec deck or the pec fly because again, it is dumbbells. And so it doesn't kind of have that same constant tension. You can get a very good stretch at the bottom of the movement, which is very good, whether it's an incline or a flat fly, either one is gonna be fine. However, what I have found anecdotally with myself and with clients, for whatever reason, this one seems to somewhat aggravate people's shoulders. You're even gonna see in my demonstration here, I'm not really using that much weight because I've even found for myself, just for whatever reason, this one does not agree with my joints, specifically my shoulder joint, too well. And so, hey, if you really like this exercise compared to like a cable and it doesn't feel bad on your shoulders, this is awesome. This is phenomenal. Really good stretch, really good tension, pretty much isolates the chest. But again, just from that anecdotal standpoint and kind of that learning curve where it's a free weight and you have your shoulder in all that retraction, I do find it maybe a little bit difficult for people. So I knock it down a little bit to a B. Next is decline cable flies. This one, I gotta give an A. Another super, super awesome chest exercise where you have those arms of the cable machine at a high point. You can have a really nice wide grip and you can bring them down and get a good squeeze and tension at the bottom. Again, it's selectorized, so super easy to adjust the load. It's pretty safe profile. Because the tension is constant, you get a really good stretch, really good feeling, and it's fluid throughout the movement. The only kind of limiting factor here is because you're standing, you kind of get to a point where, you know, your lower body kind of is having trouble stabilizing you and your upper body can kind of do it. There's also the ability for you to cheat this one a little bit where people start bending their arms quite a bit and kind of turn into like a hybrid press and fly. Not that that's bad, but of course you want to keep the arms as straight as possible and get a good squeeze at the bottom. So really outside of the slight issues with it being standing and stabilizing your lower body, this is a phenomenal, phenomenal chest exercise that I can modify quite a bit and got good tension throughout the movement. Next is dips. Dips are a phenomenal staple exercise. It's body weight, so you can do it in a lot of places. However, even though it's a body weight exercise, it can be quite difficult to do if you're someone who is new to the gym. Of course, you can do dips assisted with a band or with a machine, but it is also a very good foundational exercise, kind of like a push-up. I'm gonna give this one a B. Okay. You can get a very, very good deep stretch with a dip. You can make sure that you overload it simply by just using your body weight for a little bit higher reps. You can add weight around yourself. It's a very simple exercise to do. And again, if you need to regress it, you can do things like assisted dips. The only issue I kind of find with it is, again, I have had clients, not myself personally, but I've had a lot of clients anecdotally say it does put a lot of tension on the shoulder where they don't feel like, yeah, I feel my chest working a little bit. Some people say they more so feel it in their triceps, but it really aggravates kind of the anterior portion of your shoulder. You can modify their body position a little bit to help it out, but I just find that most people, it kind of, or at least a good amount of people, they find that it aggravates their shoulder a bit compared to some other exercises. And so there is kind of that limiting factor, a little bit of learning curve, making sure it doesn't aggravate the shoulder, but overall it's a pretty solid chest exercise. I'm gonna give this one a B, like I said. Next, we got the machine chest press. And this one, I'm also gonna give an S tier. This is a phenomenal, phenomenal chest exercise. And I'm gonna put a little caveat, a machine chest press where the arms, again, converge together at the top. There are a lot of machines where your arms kind of just stay in the same position, kind of like basically doing a machine bench press. I'm talking about one like a hammer strength plate loaded or any kind of selectorized or plate loaded machine where the arms actually come together at the top. It's basically like doing a seated bench press, but with all the benefit of the dumbbells where we talked about where the arms come together. Super safe. It's on a fixed track, so there's not as much stability requirements. Really easy to load. It can go from basically 0 pounds with no plates or a very light load on the selectorized, or you can load it as heavy as you want to. And of course, usually you can adjust the arms to get into a really, really deep stretch, further than you could with a bench press. And again, it's super safe and super effective. I don't really have any negatives to this exercise. As long as you set it up, it's super safe, super effective. Again, this one is a phenomenal exercise that if you're working on your chest and your gym has access to it, you gotta have it in your program. Next is the push-up. Now, I would say if you were talking to, you know, a high school student or someone who is like just getting into the gym, the push-up is a phenomenal staple exercise, just like a bodyweight squat or a pull-up, right? It gives you a good understanding of your body, gives you a good understanding of how do I develop the upper part or the upper portion of my body, specifically the chest, the shoulders, and the triceps. But as you get really good at doing push-ups, as you get stronger, you kind of get to the point where you have to do a crap ton of push-ups in order to get kind of the same stimulus. Yeah, you can add some weight. Yeah, you can add a band around you, but for all the work that you're doing and all the setup you're doing, you're probably better off doing something like bench press variation or machine chest variation. And so while a good staple starting out, overall for developing the chest, I would say the push-up is kind of eh overall. So I'm gonna give this one a C, right? Your arms aren't really converging. You are pushing, but at some point you're gonna be doing 50, 60 reps when you get really, really good at it. And is that the best use of your time when you could be doing sets of 8 to 12, going close to failure on something like machine chest press? The other thing with the push-up too is while it can be easily modified by making an incline or putting your feet above your head, some people a push-up can be very difficult when they're first starting out, right? Where let's say you're someone who has a lot of excess body weight, even doing an incline push-up can be quite challenging versus doing like a machine chest press with 15 or 20 pounds that you can handle, but your body weight doing an incline push-up might be extraordinarily difficult. And so yes, easy to modify, but for certain individuals can also be a very hard entry point, even if you change it. Next is the hex press. If you've never seen this before, this is usually where you have two dumbbells close together. Think like a close grip dumbbell bench press, but I have the dumbbells touching. You even see some variations where people do a plate press where they take a plate, push it together and press. This one's not very good, unfortunately. I'm gonna give this one a D. Reason being, yes, I am pressing, right, like a bench press, but I don't have a really good stretch at the bottom of the movement, where like I said, you wanna have the arms come apart at the bottom, get a really good stretch in the chest. And the range of motion is quite shortened because the dumbbells are stopping pretty early in my chest, kind of at the top here. Or if you're using that plate, your grip kind of becomes a limiting factor. And there's a little bit of a safety concern as it gets quite heavy to where, dang, what if this thing slips and hits me right smack in the chest mid-set? Not the best thing to have. Yeah, you're working your chest. Yeah, it does a little bit something. But again, because this range of motion here is quite short and I don't get much movement in the shoulder other than a little bit of pressing, not the best exercise. I gotta give this one a D. Next is the dumbbell pullover. This is one of those examples of an exercise that a lot of people do it for the chest. And you may say you feel it a little bit, but it's a lot more activation in kind of the lats, maybe the triceps. It is true that by doing that pulling over exercise going into shoulder extension, the chest does do that, but it doesn't really put a lot of great emphasis. There is obviously a setup thing where you have to get comfortable like being in that bridge position on a bench. You have to be comfortable holding that dumbbell, especially as it gets heavier. It can be kind of awkward to go into full extension with your arms overhead with a 50, 60, 70 plus pound dumbbell. That can start to get awkward. And again, the lats are kind of the prime mover there. And so while it does work the chest a little bit, it's not really focusing on the chest like we want it to. So kind of other muscles are carrying over, not really specific for the chest. I gotta give this one an F, not my go-to exercise here at all. And lastly, we're gonna talk about two, which is going to be the Smith Machine Bench Press and the Smith Machine Incline Bench Press. Both of these are gonna get A's here, right? These are phenomenal. They have all the benefits of a bench press, but now they're on a fixed track. People might think, oh, Smith Machine, that's weak, that's silly, right? No, not at all. When I'm talking about building muscle, I wanna try my best to have the movement be as controlled and as isolating as possible. And so yes, while there's benefit for having stability, like with a dumbbell or like with a barbell, if I wanna target and focus on the muscle as much as possible, having it on a fixed track, like a machine, like a Smith machine, it's gonna be phenomenal for muscle development. What's really nice too is it's very safe, right? So the bar usually ranges from like 10 to 20, 25 pounds, depending on what machine you use. So you can start very light. Whereas like if you're using a barbell, maybe you only have a 45 pound barbell in your gym and that may be too heavy to start out. So really good entry. and you have a spotter, right? If you're doing a rep trying to go like close to failure and you get stuck at the bottom, you're like, holy crap, I can't get up. You don't want to have that awkward moment where you're going to call someone for help. You can just rack it. So super safe, super easy to load. You don't have to worry about getting a spotter, and it really isolates the chest. Again, the traditional Smith machine bench and incline bench press, both these are getting A tier. They are phenomenal exercises. And so now that we have the entire list here, the one that I'm crowning the best chest exercise, in my opinion, the one that gets S tier plus, is gonna be that seated machine chest press, specifically the one where the arms come together, they converge at the top. Again, all the benefits of a bench press, all the benefits of a dumbbell bench press, super easy to do, super easy to learn. This is phenomenal. So if you can only do one chest exercise, that's the one I'm picking. But again, what matters most is that you find exercises that work for you, ones you have access to, ones that don't aggravate your joints, and ones that feel good on the chest and give you a good stretch. So if you like any of these, I would be sure to include them in your program. You really build up your chest, gonna get to the goals that you want. And that's it, everyone. Hey, I hope y'all enjoyed this video again. Please be sure, as always, to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Again, let Coach D know, do you agree or do you disagree? Are there certain ones you're like, absolutely, these are my favorite? Or are there ones you're like, Coach, you're way out of line here. This one is the best and here's why. Please let me know. I'd love to hear what y'all have to say in the comments down below. And as always, tune in. We have videos coming every other week, daily content on the socials. If you wanna come work with me down here in South Florida or virtually, let me know by going to my website or sending me a DM. And I look forward to seeing y'all in the next one. Later, everyone.